So yesterday night we have reached Occupied State Park in Pennsylvania. So we have set up our tent, wake up in the morning, had our bath, and now taking some odds. Yesterday night was wonderful, especially staying in the park. There are so many stars in the sky. At night, we really enjoyed it. Tonight also we are staying here. How is your camping experience? Robert Stroman, Ohio Pile, Schutz, Killarney, Fairbanks.
It's all good, but except for this day was the freezing night.
Yeah. Yesterday night was a little freezy. And we felt cold at night. But it's okay. Now it's summer. But still, I don't know. It was a little freezy yesterday night. You're making coffee?
In the morning.
In the morning? This time we have booked electric campground. Want coffee?
No, coffee.
Want coffee?
No.
Jumping
on the bed.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Give me your back a little bit of massage.
No! Hey, bouncy
hey,
people!
Hey.
Bouncy
people! Jumping is when you bouncy.
Bouncy people!
So this was our camping setup at Ohio Pile State Park. Very comfy. Kathy, Jonathan, Papa, and Mommy. Wow.
We also have like this other bouncy bed. Really good,
so it's a 10-person tent.
And
so comfortably fit a queen, a two double bed.
And also this super
and
bag.
A sleeping mattress. And our luggages and everything.
There's also,
and
there's also
the height of the tent is
super high.
Super
ceiling.
High. So I cannot even touch the ceiling. Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry. I cannot even touch the ceiling, so it's so high. This is outbound 10-person camping tent. We highly recommend this product. Good. So we have gone through so many camping tents. Many of them doesn't have height, so that will become a little difficult when we crawl inside. But in this tent, we can just walk inside and just feel like a room. It's a big room with a. All the windows on the sides can be opened.
And the
grass.
That makes it more ventilated.
And also there's a nest, so that means no flies.
Yeah, the net, no fly, and there's a rain fly.
Is it my solar door?
On the top. So hopefully this will be a good product. I'm not sure about how this product will be during the rain, but I think it'll be okay. I'm not saying that this is perfect, but it'll be okay. But for summer and fall, this is a very good product. The thickness of the bottom is not that good, but okay, that's why I've said it is good for summer and fall, but I'm not so sure about rainy condition. So we have bought additional two polyethylene, I don't know what the product is, some kind of tarpa. We have brought basically a product we got from Canadian Tire, and that helps to
like make sure to float,
get protected from water in case of rainfall. To install this, it will take a minimum 15 minutes. Not that easy, I say, but it's possible. A bit difficult, especially when connecting the rod. But once it is connected, this is so amazing. Yeah, this is the tarpa that I am talking about. Different varieties are available based on thickness, which can be used to protect from rainfall. In case it can be put on both sides, we have put one inside the tent, and so this goes underneath, so that will protect from rainfall in case.
Okay.
And this is the cover, it can be closed.
All the way to the end. Wait, wait. It wants to take them. Ah!
And
you have to
keep
walking. Like this, you have to touch it like that.
How it looks. So this is the electric post. So there is 30 amps, basically I think for trailers, and there are two power outlets, and this is basically for connecting the camper vans, the big one. So a separate outlet is required for this one, and but this is for normal use. This is the camping port, electric port.
Papa, Papa.
Yeah. This is the fire kit we have in use. Our campsite is 48 in the Cherry Road. Campsite is not that big, but I can say medium size campsite, and that is near the washroom. Good.
that is going to fill water.
How do you do that?
Put the water.
Yeah, bigger, some water.
Okay.
Put the water.
So June 8th, media festival. For tonight. A big tree. So many trees in the back also. Really wooded. The back side.
And so far the bathroom haven't had one problem.
And 548 is near to the washroom, so that'll make things super easy. And that is the freezer, which makes everything cool.
Jonathan is right now playing his car on the car. Can't go through that.
Jonathan is playing his car on my car, but that makes my car scratchy.
I think he always scratches. There's a little scratch
Up. Okay.
I did it. I
want to try this one. This one would be easier. Jonathan.
It would be easier for me, not for you. So this is the children play area in Ohio Pile, and that's our campsite 48. So the play area is very near. So, children's play area in Ohio Pile.
Big people are also here.
Yeah, it's so. Things getting interesting.
Look! Oh, I saw that! Help me!
You guys are enjoying. What happened? You didn't stop?
Oh,
so, we started enjoying this camping. So this is day 2 of our camping over here. Pile State Park. Tonight also we are staying here. Jonathan, how is it? Water is available here also. There's a washroom and drinking water area very near to site 48. Our site 48 is in Cherry Road.
are just going outside to the nearby town for some food. We are going to explore few areas in Ohio Pile State Park. So first we are going to Fern Cliff Natural Area, and there are various places to explore here in Ohio Pile. There are so many waterfalls in this park, like Cucumber Falls is a famous one. There are so many other falls. We need to go through the map and to see which one to explore first. Where to decide. So now we are going to Fern Cliff Natural Area. So that is the main entrance of the campground. Now we are outside the campground, but we are still in the Ohio Pile State Park. So we need to find where to go. That side is the Kenta campground.
This side? Campground road.
So that's the campground road.
towards the left is north 381
hard coffee Laurel Highlands Falls area. That's where we have to stop.
Okay,
Laurel Highlands Falls area,
the Laurel Highlands park area,
Falls area.
Okay, Anu is looking into the map and she's guiding me,
guiding you.
Yeah.
Up two.
Oh. Ohio Pine Farms area, Department of Conservation and Natural Resources. If you had to turn right here. Fully packed in the long weekend. We are looking for a parking. So we got our parking. Here there's a very big waterfall. The entire area is fully packed. Lucky that we got a parking lot. Everyone is enjoying the long weekend here. So this is the waterfall area. Okay.